Would you trust AI to make financial decisions and pick stocks for you? Well, if you said yes, you're not alone. Millions of people are turning to Robo Advisors for financial advice. In fact, the numbers are staggering as to how many people are using Robo Advisors and artificial intelligence to make some of the most important decisions of their lives. But look, don't take my word for it. Today, we're going to look at a couple different surveys and studies that are showing the actual numbers. And this is an exploding industry, boys. And I think that it's really important that we highlight this because, again, as men going into a crazy, crazy, tumultuous world, we gotta remain relevant, respected, and financially free. How do we do that? We study the market, we understand what's happening, we understand what AI is doing. And if that is you, this is the time to hit like and subscribe. All right, guys, let's go. Today, we're going to cover both the implications of robo-advisors to the home stock traders, the retail investors, and to financial advisors, because these are two slightly different groups, but the implications are many. So let's look at this study from eToro. eToro completed what I would consider quite a large survey of 11,000 retail investors. And the results were pretty surprising to me. Maybe they're not to you, I don't know. You're pretty intelligent. You're watching a channel like this. You must be smart and incredibly handsome too, of course. Anyway, they found that 13% of retail investors are actively using ChatGPT for stock selection. And 50% are open to using AI to make those portfolio decisions. And when we say like, well, what are they asking? What do they mean by using AI? Well, here's some examples, some of the questions that they might ask. What stock should I buy? It doesn't get any more black and white than that. How should I allocate my access, my assets? What is the fee structure? What is the expected return and volatility of my portfolio? How do I optimize for taxes? Like, you could start to really drill down on this. And you can start to see how a tool like ChatGPT can make you at least feel much more well informed on these stocks. But it doesn't just end there. There was another survey by Finder that found 40% of UK traders were already using chatbots for financial advice. I'll give you an example of a prompt that you might use and a prompt that they are using. Assume you're a short analyst. What is the short thesis for this stock? So imagine you're watching CNBC, like, should I do that? Before you invest in the stock, before you listen to Jim Cramer, which you should probably do the opposite of, before you listen to Jim Cramer, you go to ChatGPT and you ask for ChatGPT's insights. You're gonna feel like a genius because it's gonna give you bullet points and pros and cons. And again, the better you are at prompting, the better you are at asking the right questions, the better the responses you're going to get. Anyway, I found that very interesting. Here's another case study from Finder. They performed an experiment in March of 2023, guys. That's over 2 years ago. And let me tell you something, AI has gotten a lot better since then. Anyway, March 2023, Finder tasked ChatGPT with curating a basket of 38 different stocks. And this portfolio has surged 55% since then and is outperforming the UK's top 10 mutual funds by almost 19 percentage points. What does that tell you? Well, it tells you that this AI bot traded better than the most intelligent, most well-capitalized companies and investment funds in the entire world. Now, granted, they could be a little bit more risky and we got to look, maybe they used a bunch of different portfolios and, you know, maybe they're just sharing their wins. I don't know. And it's a little bit different when you have real skin in the game. You know, when they're running simulations, you could be a lot more risky and so on and so forth. But in any event, I think that that data point is very, very interesting. But you might say, well, Mark, you know, this is probably slowing down. AI isn't real, Mark. I know you guys love to tell me that AI isn't real, that it's always India. You guys, wake the hell up, man. Wake up. Reuters estimates that robo-advisory chatbots will increase from $62 billion industry to a $470 billion industry by 2029. That's a 600% expected increase. And, you know, you might say, Mark, that's a projection. How do they know? We make decisions about the future based on what's happened in the past. And AI robo advisors are absolutely exploding. But what you might be asking yourself is, Mark, is this a good thing? Is it a bad thing? Should we be using AI to make financial decisions? Well, let's look at the pros and cons here, because I think it is relevant. So the first thing I'm going to say is that having a PhD level expert in your pocket for anything is going to be pretty valuable. Granted, there are some cons to it, but you're going to be more well-informed, or at the very least, feel more well-informed, and we'll get to the cons in just a moment. But what I like about these robo-advisors is they're fast, 24/7, they're extremely inexpensive to operate. They have access to basically all the news on the internet if prompted properly. And you know, they're gonna be pretty solid at predicting value. Now again, the better your inputs, the better your outputs. So some robo traders are gonna be better than others. You know, are you just gonna use a stock standard ChatGPT? Maybe. Might be better to use something that has more advanced first party data or has better training. You know, one of the problems you can run into with LLMs is if they're scraping data and information from untrustworthy sources, you can get bad advice. There, I'll give you a case in point. There was an example that happened last year where people were asking Gemini questions like, how do I get the cheese to stick on my pizza? And Gemini is scraping Reddit for answers and decides to recommend using glue to stick the cheese on. Not great advice, okay? So again, the better your first party data, the better your results are going to be, the better your outputs are gonna be. The other thing that I think is interesting here that I like, in, you know, something that we talk about on the channel occasionally, is that there's this growing wealth gap between the people that are using AI and the people that are not. The companies that are gonna be hyper efficient because of AI, and the companies that are like, no, AI is so scary, we can't use it. Stupid, by the way. But anyway, there's a growth there, you know, there's an idea that there's gonna be a very large growing wealth gap. And just again, side note, I don't care if there's people out there that are rich or richer than me. I don't care. Is the question I ask, is my life getting better? Am I able to do things that I enjoy? Am I stressed out about finances? I don't care that there's billionaires and trillionaires out there. I really don't care. I just want to make sure that my family is fed, that I have freedom, I can worship the way I want to worship, like I have free speech. Like, that's what I care about. You know, I really don't care if there's billionaires out there. Envy is a bad thing, guys. Don't succumb to envy. Envy, no good. At any rate, what's cool about this is that on the other side of this foot is that the AI really democratizes and spreads out the wisdom and information. You don't need to go to school and take all these complicated tests to get pretty good information from an AI chatbot. It's, again, it's like having a PhD in your pocket. So this is gonna make you as an investor much more well-informed on any particular topic, and in this case, financial investments. Now, the downsides there are is that these AI bots, well, they can be kind of crazy sometimes. Hallucinations are a problem. We talked about having limited data sets, or if they're pulling the wrong inputs from different areas. There's compliance issues. You know, in order to trade certain types of products, you need to have certain certifications, licenses. And the big one is scams. Guys, there are tons and tons of scams going on. I recorded a video on this. I'll post a link to it here. But the amount of scams and frauds using AI are just exploding right now. There's been somewhat of a 456% increase in AI scams over the last year. Check out that video. It's pretty shocking, the stories on what's happening. In any event, there's some pros or some cons, so buyer beware. Now, for advisors, I think that this is pretty interesting, because you might say, holy cow, the robo-advisors are taking all of the jobs. Where do I stand? You know, am I even gonna have a job anymore? Everyone's using robo-advisors. Well, all these pros are mentioned above, but I think where this is actually a huge advantage for advisors, because you're able to critically think, you're able to use your wisdom, you're able to take in all of this data and all of these suggestions, and you're able to find things that are off, and you're able to ask better questions. So I see these robo-advisors as actually a huge benefit. You know, all that time you spent before doing, you know, researching summaries and, you know, planning out proposals and writing it down, doing client education, all that kind of like that busy work that doesn't really add a lot of value can be taken off the table, so you can spend more time face to face with, you know, families, business executives, and making sure that you're giving them the most personalized service possible. actually recorded a video a couple days ago, I'll post a link to it here, about how auto mechanics are using AI already. I was speaking to a friend of mine, he manages a large region of auto mechanic chains, and they're using AI in some really, really cool ways to be very, very efficient. It's almost like having one or two employees in your office that are just making everything run smoothly. It's really, really cool video. I definitely think you should check that out. You'll be amazed at what's already happening there. And I see that happening for the financial advisors too. Basically everyone. Everyone's gonna be using these AI bots, but the financial advisors I think is an interesting place to go to. Now, what I think is interesting here and something to be aware of is that your clients, guys, are gonna be way more informed. They're gonna be way more informed because they have a PhD in their pocket. So just be prepared. The types of questions that your clientele are gonna be asking is gonna be much more advanced. And they're gonna have the capacity to smell out BS much more easily. You're gonna give them a proposal, they're gonna plug it into ChatGPT, and they're gonna say something like, where are the gaps in the reasoning? Why is this a good idea? Why is this a bad idea? What are the other options? Is he BSing me? They're gonna be able to sniff out the bullcrap way easier. And again, this comes across everything. You know, guys, if you're thinking you're gonna send out a proposal to someone or a prospectus or a proposed portfolio and they're not gonna plug it into ChatGPT, you are nuts. Everybody's gonna be doing this. So you need to make sure that you're prepared with good answers. Anyway, I think it's a fascinating topic. When I saw the numbers, when I saw what's happening, the amount of growth in the industry, how many people are using these bots, I was shocked, not totally shocked, but I thought it was really interesting. I'm glad to be able to share it here with you guys on the channel. If you really want more, you definitely need to subscribe to my newsletter, the AIupdate.ai. It's totally free. The best news, the best tips, the best prompts, go to AIupdate.ai and I will keep you in the loop, guys. That is my commitment to you. And before you leave, I just wanted to hear from you. Would you trust an AI advisor? Would you trust that? Are you using an AI advisor? Let's do a quick survey here amongst all the members of this community, which I appreciate. Plug it in, boys. Plug in your comment. Would you use AI? I want to see it below. All right, boys, make it great. I'll see you in the next video, which is right here. And we're talking about how employers have stopped hiring. Pretty nuts. I'll see you there, boys. See ya. Peace.